Welcome students. My name is Reeva Rithinia Pace, Assistant Professor in Commerce, Government College of Arts, Science and Commerce, KPE. Today, I will be speaking about the barriers to become entrepreneur and entrepreneurial competencies. Before moving to the barriers, who is an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is a person who establishes his own business with a view of making profits. He undertakes risk of starting something so that he can fulfill his dreams to achieve awards or to achieve rewards in the form of profits. So while doing his business or during his course of business, he undertakes risk and expect huge amount of returns. But there are some obstacles or hurdles that he comes across in the course of his business. And these hurdles are called as barriers. They are called as obstacles that acts as a barrier in achieving something or make things difficult for an entrepreneur in functioning his day-to-day business. The barriers to entrepreneur can be classified into three broad categories, that is, environmental barrier, personal barrier and social barrier. Now, when we talk about environmental barrier, they are the ones which are caused by the environment and an entrepreneur has no control over these barriers. They act as an hurdle for an entrepreneur to run his business. So, environmental barriers limit or prevent an entrepreneur in getting his work done with maximum capacity. The first environmental barrier is raw material. Any business requires resources to function. The resources could be man, money, material, machines. Raw material is one of the most important resource for any business. Without raw material, the business cannot function. So, non-availability of this raw material, if the raw material is not available, it is costly. It increases the cost of production. So an entrepreneur will be constantly in search of raw material wherein he can get it at reduced prices. So if the raw material is in shortage, and that too when there is peak season, that too when there is lot of demand in the market, then it becomes a barrier to become an entrepreneur. Then it becomes a hurdle for an entrepreneur. What should I do now? The prices are high. I need to buy the raw material. I need to produce. If I don't, someone else will enter the market, will give the product to my consumers. The consumer will buy his products later on. So, non-availability of raw material act as an environmental barrier for an entrepreneur. Next thing is labor. It is also an important resource of any organization. You need to find the right person to do the right job. So, if you have hired manpower and these people are just leaving your organization and going and joining some other organization. You don't have loyal employees. You are finding it difficult to get skilled, efficient people for your for running your business. Then again, it becomes a barrier. Next thing is machinery. Machinery is necessary for the purpose of production. You require machinery. You require different types of machines. Sometimes, as the environment, the technological environment, there is development taking place. The old machinery becomes obsolete. You need to replace this machinery. And it becomes difficult for small business organization to keep pace with the change in technology. If you are using an old, outdated technology, or obsolete technology, your production process is outdated, the cost of production increases. So it becomes a hurdle when you need to replace the technology, an old, outdated technology. So this also acts as a barrier for an entrepreneur. Lack of funds. Entrepreneur needs money. He requires funds to run a business. Now you can arrange funds from your own savings, or you might borrow it from your friends, relatives, banks, or other financial institutions. But sometimes it becomes difficult to get money. So many people do not enter into do not start their own business because they cannot gather the required amount of funds. Infrastructure support. When we speak about infrastructure, we take into consideration land, building, roads, cheap power, transportation facilities, water, electricity. All these things are required so that you can have, you can carry on with your production. If this infrastructure facilities are not available, it affects the growth of entrepreneurship. So, infrastructure support is required for an entrepreneur. If it is not there, then again, it acts as a barrier. Next thing is the other factors that act as environmental barriers, that is your lack of education. The person who wants to start the business don't know how to move about. The government is not supporting, is asking for a lot of money to give you various no objection certificates to approve your plan. The cost of production is high, then you don't have that much market knowledge. There's a lot of competition in the market going on. All these things act as environmental barriers, which again obstruct the entrepreneur to fulfill his dreams. So then, these are the environmental barriers. Then there are some personal barriers. When we talk about personal barriers, they are directly linked to an individual, a particular person. So they are the barriers which are emotional blocks of a person. They cause some mental blockage in the mind of an entrepreneur. And because of this reason, the entrepreneur might not go forward with his business. lack of patience. When we talk about patience, we cannot fulfill our dreams at a stretch. We want to achieve success, but just the moment I start my business, I'm not going to earn profits. It takes time. We need to wait. We need to face the challenges and problems so that we achieve success. We cannot become rich immediately. So the desire to achieve success in the first attempt and to become rich soon is one of the motivating factors of modern youth. They want success very fast. When such dreams don't become true, you don't get a lot of customers in the beginning, then you become disappointed. You give up on your business. So initially you need time. You need time to earn profits. You have to first recover the cost which you have incurred. So patience is what is required. And if that patience is not there, you cannot become an entrepreneur. Lack of confidence. An entrepreneur must have confidence. Must have confidence in himself and in the idea which he wants to work on. They need to be determined to achieve something. They need to have full confidence. Many people think that they lack that drive to become an entrepreneur. They feel that their idea might not work out. They don't have the skills. And because of this, they are reluctant to become an entrepreneur. They feel they reject the idea of becoming self-employed. They feel they don't have the skills. So to become an entrepreneur, you need to be confident. You need to have an idea in which you trust, in which you can put more and more efforts, and you should know that I can grow up with this idea. So if you don't have confidence, again, it becomes a barrier. Unwillingness to invest money. You might have money in hand, but you don't want to take the risk. Without risk, there are no returns. So there are people who have money, still they do not become entrepreneur. Why? Because they don't want to take the risk of investing their money. They feel, okay, today if I invest my money, I might not get adequate returns. So instead of investing in some business, let me keep it in bank. So if you have people with those type of attitude, then the entrepreneurship does not take place. Lack of motivation, lack of support. When an individual wants to start a new venture, he's full of enthusiasm and he wants to achieve success. But if some obstacles, some challenges come between, then they cannot face these challenges. The motivation level which was there, the enthusiasm which was there in the beginning, that is gone. I can do, I can achieve, all these things are ended up with the challenges which are forward. And then you see, I can't do it. I can't achieve it. So when the challenges come, because when you are doing business, lot of things will come between. There will be more and more competitors looking at you being successful. More and more competitors will enter the market. You need to face challenges. You need to study your product. You need to redesign your product. You need to face the losses, bear the losses. You should be constantly motivated. That self-motivation needs to be there. If this self-motivation is not there, you cannot face the challenges, again, it becomes a barrier. Inability to dream. Entrepreneurs who are short of vision or become satisfied with what they achieve sometimes lose interest in future expansion. They feel, okay, whatever I have done is enough. Whatever profits I'm getting, I'm happy with those profits. I don't want to go beyond. Wherever I am, it's fine. If you are of those, if you take that type of things in mind, if you don't want to dream, you will be there only. Someone else will enter the market, will capture the market. Nobody will buy your product. You need to think big. You need to think about the future. You need to do a lot of research so that you remain in business. If you don't have to achieve something to fight the competition, if you don't think big, your business won't prosper and you won't become successful. So these are the personal barriers. The next one are your social barriers. The social barriers are basically something that comes from the society. You don't get that much support from the society where you live. The society, the social environment is not supportive towards entrepreneurship. Low status. The society thinks that entrepreneurs are people who exploit the society. They feel that entrepreneurs are the people who try to make profits at their cost. If the society is not viewing you in a particular angle, then you have a bad impression about entrepreneurs in your mind. So, if the people around you are not ready to accept you, here again it becomes a barrier. Custom and tradition of people. People want government jobs. They want to be as an employee. They don't want to become, they don't want to run their own business. So, if you don't want to run something, if you don't want to start something, if you don't want to be your boss, if you don't want to be your own boss, then you cannot be an entrepreneur. Sometimes even people who have their own business, they don't want their children to join them. They want their children to start working for someone else to get the government jobs. If the custom and traditions don't support you, they put you away from entrepreneurship, then again, this becomes a barrier. After the barriers, the next thing is your entrepreneurial competencies. When we talk about competencies, they are basically the skills, some capabilities required to be an entrepreneur. Okay, so entrepreneurial competencies are the skills required by an entrepreneur for starting a business venture. And just not starting, but also carrying it on successfully. Every entrepreneur must take decisions, crucial decisions in the course of his business. Constantly, decisions need to be taken regarding who will be my supplier, what kind of business will I start, where will I start my business, what will be my marketing strategy. You need to take crucial decisions. So, entrepreneur must be a good decision maker. He must analyze the situations, understand what exactly is required, what decision he must take. So he has to analyze various situations around him and take a correct decision. Throughout the entire entrepreneurial process, he comes across various things on which he has to take decisions. So an entrepreneur must have the decision-making skill. He must have the skill of understanding which direction I should go, which supplier should I select, which supplier will give me good facilities. I might have to buy the raw material, I might take the raw material today, might give me an extra period for making the payment later. So he has to take the right decision at the right time. He cannot delay also on the decision. So he should be a good decision maker. Initiative. This is one of the fundamental or an important competency required by an entrepreneur. You need to take the initiative. You need to take the first step before the competitor takes. You need to identify the opportunity. You need to grab the opportunity so that before anyone else takes the advantage, you need to be the first one to start something, to do that particular thing. He should have the willingness to take the step of starting the enterprise. Just thinking, I want to do this, that, this will be there. Just dreaming is not enough. You need to take the initiative. You need to move towards your goal. Interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills is basically when you are running your business, you are not going to run your business in isolation. You need to move out. You need to interact with people. You need to interact with your customers. You need to interact with other clients. You need to interact with suppliers. You need to interact with the banking officials. You need to interact with various types of people. You need to work well with others. You need to interact with your employees. You need good communication skills. Just not talking. You need to listen, understand your employees so that you can mix up with others. So an entrepreneur must have interpersonal skills of dealing and communicating with people around him. Organizational skills. Organizational skills is basically about coordinating and managing the business. You need to identify from where I am going to get my resources. Put together all the factors of production and convert it into a final product, that is a finished product. You need to see that you organize your business well so that your business prospers. You need to manage the business and see that all get the things, you need to get the things done from the people who are working for you. You need to know, you need to organize, classify and see that you get the best things out of your employees. So you need to put things in place, organize it in a nice possible manner so that you can get the most out of the resources which are available. Stress management. In the course of business, you will come across lot of obstacles. Suddenly you might come to know that you run short of finance. There's a lot of work pending. I have to fulfill so and so orders. The work might pressurize you. You need to put efforts. You need to think positive. You need to keep your mind cool. You must see that this situation will pass off. You need to handle yourself. There will be workload, there will be a lot of work, but keeping yourself in place, understanding the requirements, understanding that you must not take decisions just for the sake of taking the decision. You need to understand the situation. You simply under stress, you cannot take decisions. So you need to handle the stress well. You have to put efforts, because efforts will pay off. They will, if you put efforts today, if you try to come out, you have to put out all the stress, and if you try to concentrate on your business will grow, your business will prosper. You know, you must know as an entrepreneur to handle stress. Stress management is very important for an entrepreneur. He needs to hold his cool and understand and concentrate on his work, put efforts, and see that you get things as per planned. Next thing is valuing service and diversity. When you talk about diversity, there will be people coming from different culture. You must be able, or you must adjust with all these people. You must see that you understand your employees. You must work, recognize, give importance to everybody. You cannot differentiate people working with you. You must consider, respect their culture. You must respect them as an individual. There will be various challenges that you will come across in the course of business. You need to understand and based on that respond. There will be different type of people, when they are working in an organization, the workforce will be of different type. You need to value, respect, recognize and understand these people as an individual. They might be coming from various background. You need to understand them and motivate them. If you make differences among people, tomorrow they might caution you. Tomorrow they might act as an obstacle and they might not understand and trust you. So you need to consider all the employees equal and value each and every individual and respect them. And if you provide this, if you work like this, they will come up, diverse people, different type of people, they will come up with new ideas which can actually work out in your business. So you respect your employees, respect your workforce, recognize them, in return they will turn out to be the asset for your business. You have to see that you consider all employees equal. You have to value, you have to respect the service which they provide you, and you need to respect each one of them as an individual. Thank you, Sri.